All right, this video is for the youngsters. If you're a young graphic designer, 18, 19, or 20 years old, and you wanna up your design game, you actually wanna start a design business and start creating an income for yourself, this is gonna be the video for you. I'm gonna talk about the advantages, not the disadvantages, of being a young graphic designer. I was a young graphic designer, and I know what that's all about. There are some challenges, but we're gonna focus on the positive. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into it. Hey guys, welcome back to another Adrian Graphics and Marketing video. Excited to have you guys back here. And what I need from you guys is to hit that thumbs up button, give me a like so that YouTube shows my content to more people. It's really, really important. And then hit the subscribe button so I know that you're seeing the content and you can get updated every single time we post a new video, which is Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. So today's video is for the young graphic designers, the guys that are out there and gals that are out there trying to build their graphic design business. I wanna go through the five different things that I think are advantages of being a young graphic designer, and we're not gonna talk about the disadvantages, but we wanna focus on the positive things because I wanna get your mind in the right place for success. I know this personally because I started as a young graphic designer. In 2005, I was doing it as a hobby, doing printing and graphic design for club flyers, restaurants, and small businesses. And my career has grown to a six-figure agency owner, and now I'm a CEO of a creative agency and a consulting business, and I have other businesses as well. But my journey started off at a very young age. At 18, 19 years old, when I started doing this as a business, I was just charging about $30 per flyer, making anywhere between $8 and $15 an hour on the high side. Nowadays, when I go out and do consulting, I can generate over $1,000 an hour on consulting work, and as a graphic designer, I can generate $150 to $250 an hour on average, depending on the type of client and the projects that I take on. So it's really important to understand that starting when you're young is key because you're going to gain a lot of experience. So let's just go ahead and jump into the first one. Number one is that it costs almost nothing to start a graphic design business. Whether you have a cheap rinky-dink computer like I had when I started, I think I had a cheap Acer that had a really terrible graphics card, and a cheap software, you can do free softwares that are out there, or you can do an affordable software like Adobe, which is what I would recommend, because there's a lot of resources, a lot of training, like in my group, on my YouTube channel, and on other YouTube channels like Terry White. Those types of things will give you the resources that you need to actually use Photoshop, use Adobe Illustrator, and actually produce really good quality work right out of the gate. It's gonna really help you save a lot of time too. So that's an investment you're gonna have to make, but it's very minimal. Nowadays, you can get into Creative Cloud for $20, $30 a month. So when I started as a graphic designer, that was the big thing for me, is I didn't have a whole lot of money. I was coming out of jail, trying to figure out what I was gonna do with my life, and I knew I had design abilities and artistic creative abilities, but I didn't know how I was gonna make money with it. And it wasn't until I actually just started, which is what I want you guys to do, is just to get started in doing graphic design for a small amount of money, before I realized that there was actually a lot of demand for being a graphic designer and for the type of work that I was going after. Okay, now number two is bills. When you're young, you have very little bills and you don't have a family to support most times. You may be a teen mom or a teen dad, but most of the time you're not having to support a family and people, so it's just you that you have to be responsible for. And it doesn't take a whole lot of money nowadays, unless you live in California, to survive. So that's another beauty, is you can go out there and be a lot more competitive with your pricing than I can. I have a wife, I have three children, I have an office space, I have employees, I have a team. You have an advantage to be able to go out there and compete on price with me, and I can't compete on price. I have to sell value. And I want you to sell value too, but I also want you to be more competitive in the beginning so you can build a huge portfolio, you can build some great relationships. Those are gonna be some of the keys that you need to be able to stand out in the marketplace. And being young and being able to have no overhead is a huge advantage for you. All right, and number three is you're not trained by society or by normal jobs as a professional graphic designer working for a business. You have untrained eyes, you have a fresh perspective. You can go into things not knowing what's coming around the corner and go all out and not worry about the mistakes. You have this courage, this blind courage as a graphic designer when you're young. You haven't been tainted by the whole world of saying, you can't do this and you can't do that and you can't do this. You can come into it with fresh perspective, untrained eyes, and you can develop what works and what doesn't work Now, number four, you can afford to make more mistakes. Because you're young, if you make a mistake, you have time. That is the one advantage you have over me. I'm already 15 years into my career. You may be just starting. You have a lot of time to make mistakes, and I want you to go out there and make mistakes. Go out and test things, take risks, do things that are beyond your comfort zone, and challenge yourself. Even if those things don't work out, what's gonna happen is those are gonna be valuable life lessons that I want you to take away and learn from, because the best way to learn is by doing. And so by going out there and taking chances, taking risks, and putting yourself outside of your comfort zone, that's gonna give you an opportunity to learn very, very quickly. So don't be afraid, don't walk on eggshells, go after it. Do what you think is right. I made a lot of mistakes throughout my career in the very beginning when I had my print shop and sign shop. Just as an example, I opened up a print shop and then I outgrew it. And instead of actually opening up another location, I changed locations and lost 30% of my business. I'm glad I did it because it taught me a hard lesson, and the road that it led me down ended up me selling the business and making a ton of money, which led to this business. And so if I hadn't made those mistakes, I wouldn't be where I'm sitting today. So not all crisis is bad. You can turn crisis into opportunity. That's something I really want you to take away from this today, is go out there and be able to make mistakes. Don't worry about what the long-term ramifications are. Don't do wrong by people, but when I say make mistakes, is go out there and take risks. Don't be worried about failing. Failure is a natural part of being an entrepreneur. If I let fear of failure stop me, I would have stopped a long time ago. So just keep moving forward, push past the mistakes, and learn from them. When you make a mistake and you have a situation like that, you should probably journal about it and write it out, get it out of your head, get it out of your heart, forgive yourself for the mistake you made, and then ask yourself, what is the opportunity in this crisis? This is super huge. A lot of people forget to do this, but this is something I want you to do as a young entrepreneur, as a young designer, and starting your young graphic design business. Okay, and number five is really important. I want you to start now. You may be going to graphic design school or a college to learn graphic design, but it's important that you start when you're just at the very beginning so you can gain experience and start getting paid for your work. The reason why I want you to do that and how I did things a little bit differently with my business is I could have went to graphic design school, but I didn't. I was self-taught. But after I sold my business and all the dust settled, I was able to look back at my 4 years where I was building that company and understand and realize that I learned more information in those 4 years than I would have at a university, real life experience that I was able to apply. And I walked away with that with no debt. So the fact that you could actually utilize your skills now in the very beginning, even if you're an early graphic designer, to make 20, 30, 40 bucks on a graphic design piece in a day, you can start to pay yourself and pay your way through college. Whether you're going to college or you're paying your own bills, graphic design is a great skill. It's an easy skill if you just understand the basics of it to be able to make money. And you could pay for your own college. You don't need the support of your family. You don't need the support of a rich uncle. You can actually take care of yourself and pay your own way. That will give you a sense of confidence and a sense of pride in what you're doing. I know a lot of people in my community that I work with who have started businesses while they were in college and paid for their whole way through college on their own, without scholarships, without loans, without debt. And they were able to get out of college and graduate with no debt. And they had businesses that had value that were generating them money and paying their bills. And they were ahead of the curve of everybody else. And while I was actually working my butt off at 18, 19, 20, 21 years old, all of my friends were partying, sleeping on couches, sleeping at their friends' houses, living with their parents, and working part-time jobs, getting no experience, no real valuable experience. And so that's my encouragement for you guys today, is I want you to walk away with some valuable experience that you can use by starting a graphic design business right away. If you know graphic design is a passion of yours and you want to do something creative, whether it's graphic design, web design, or motion design, then start today. Even if you're not that great, you can go out on Facebook, you can go out to your friends and say, hey, can I do this project for you? And do it for free. And the repetition and the practice of doing it over and over and over again and building that portfolio, you'll get better and better to the point where very quickly you'll be able to charge and actually pay your own way for things. So that's my encouragement for you guys today. The five advantages of starting a graphic design business when you're young. And those are the things that I wanted to share. If you have any other questions, and if you want to start a graphic design business, but you're not sure how, drop your questions below in the comments. I want to hear from you. And if you want community and you want people that are going to surround you, you want mentorship and resources and trainings like this, more trainings that you're not going to see on YouTube, you definitely want to go to my Facebook group and check out the Instagraphics Pro Network. Just type in Instagraphics Pro Network on Facebook in the search. You'll see the group. Go ahead and join. All you got to do is answer one question. I made it very, very easy. And join our community. We want to see you there. And I look forward to seeing you guys on the next video. I'm Adrian Boysel, and as always, keep looking up.